Travellers to New Zealand are hurriedly booking COVID tests with new rules kicking in on the 15th of January. Some will have to show proof of a negative result before boarding their plane. But the tight frame is causing concern. Andrew McFarlane explains.
It's the latest requirement for Kiwis returning from Britain and America, but getting a negative COVID test's proving challenging for some.
Probably spent, you know, half an evening, half a morning to get that done.
Under the new rule, passengers have to return a negative result within 72 hours of check-in. But testing operators aren't open round the clock, cutting into the number of hours travellers have to work with.
I've got mine booked at 7:30 a.m. the following morning, so I'm down to 61. And then, of course, I have to check in. Now, Emirates are not going to let me on that plane unless I've got a certificate. That's 3 hours before the flight. So I'm now down to 58.
The whole ordeal is costly. People are potentially paying $3,000 for a flight home, a similar amount for a stint in managed isolation. Add on the cost of a COVID test, another $300. This scientist says the window has to be as narrow as possible in order to spot positive cases.
So you have to have an interval to allow the test to be done, and it's a fairly complicated test, so it takes time. But if you take too long of a time period, then somebody can get a negative test but be re-exposed and then end up passing it on.
He says New Zealand is at a critical point in the pandemic.
Because we have COVID well under control, there are effective vaccines on the way, but they're not here yet. So it's really important that we don't have a major outbreak now.
Andrew Barnes is taking no chances and has booked two tests.
But there are families out there that can't afford this. This is another pressure, another burden. And if it doesn't really add any value, then why are we doing it?
Officials insisting, though, it's an extra line of defence to keep COVID at bay. Andrew McFarlane, One News.